Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim Vanderzwan.
All right, let's see. How are we doing so far? Promise you a cold morning. We got that. Nothing to hold in the heat. Visible satellite from earlier today till the sun went down. Nothing but clear skies. No fog. Clouds are well offshore. And, of course, the dew points went down after a weekend of some moisture, and we ended up on the chill side of November. 32 in Scotts Valley. 38, though, in Ben Lomond. 58 was the high there. We got 64 in Santa Cruz and 66 in Watsonville. So most areas along the coast stayed above freezing, even a couple of 40s there along the beaches. But kind of chilly in Carmel Valley, starting off with 35, but bounced back up to 64 there. We got a lot of upper 50s to low 60s, so it kind of was right where we expected. Freezing in King City this morning and close to that, and 34 in Gonzales and Soledad, and that's cold enough. Even Salinas, 36. Those temperatures are measured about 5 to 6 feet off the ground, so then, you know what, you can have a little crunch on the lawn. But it rebounded nicely, mid to upper 60s there. 60s, likewise for most of Santa Clara Valley, with Gilroy getting the top number at 68. Elsewhere around the state, it squeaked out a 71 out in the desert in Palm Springs, 48 Lake Tahoe, everybody else in between. 50s and 60s pretty much did it, all the way up to about Seattle. Get inland, it's cooler. Boise, 48, 45 in Denver, and only 64 in Phoenix. It's not hot there all year long, you know. 73 in Dallas, that'll be gone tomorrow. 82 in New Orleans, 52 Chicago, 67 in New York. But it's going to change. We've got a cold front, upper level low, counterclockwise rotation. This front getting nasty. A lot of moisture yesterday just getting scooted on down the line and reconverted into thunderstorms again, as typically the case. Yesterday, a half dozen tornadoes made it into Oklahoma with some damage. Tonight, they got about 9 or 10 of them going already in Texas and Oklahoma, as this thing is moving now into Louisiana with tornado watches. Not unusual this time of year. Cold air from the backside, still warm and humid out here, and that's fueling a nasty line of thunderstorms. They'll be working toward the East Coast tomorrow. So this low will continue to move up toward Chicago. Delays likely there at the old Ord Airport, of course, Chicago O'Hare. And it'll be another day before it gets into the New England states, but should weaken by then. High pressure behind it, and another low here. And, you know, this is one of those classic cutoff lows. Notice the circulation in the isobars. That's making it a little bit tough to call. But you can already see it beginning to develop here. Another pocket of cold air stays well to the north, and this has got a little ways to go before it gets to our shore. So tomorrow's still a good day to clean out the gutters, just enjoy the day on the bay, whatever. High pressure ridge holds on through Wednesday. Then we see, as you can see, the lines of equal pressure, isobars here, close off this low. The leading edge of the precipitation ought to start working toward our sky about Thursday night. So we push some pretty good rain through in the early morning hours onto Friday, and then it begins to taper off in time for Friday night football. But you better take along some rain gear because it's going to go. If you're going down to Disneyland over the weekend, Saturday looks wet before the Southland begins to dry out. Then we still may see some scattered showers in the mix there over the weekend, but it'll be a lot more hit and miss. So with that, we've got a little bit of benefit of the heat of the day, such as it was, to get us above freezing in most stations, so we'll figure 40s for starters. 60s and even a few 70s possible. Don't know how long we can keep doing this, but we'll sneak them in there when we can. 70 in Salinas, 72 in Gonzales looks fairly reasonable. The upper 60s elsewhere, so that's close enough. And temperatures in the mid to upper 30s there. 40s along the coast, low to mid 60s around the Monterey Peninsula, so you're in good shape there. Likewise, across the bay, it'll be a beautiful day just to be out and about. And I guess with that pirate ship there at Moss Landing, if you got a chance to go for a ride, take it, matey. It'll be a good day to be on the water. Not a lot of swell action either. Clear and cool. Light east, southeast winds will keep the night stars a-going there, and then sunny and mild tomorrow. It'll be cool in the morning, but not as cold as it was this morning. And the next day, we start clouding up. We'll probably start getting some high clouds during the day, but still dry during the day with the rain developing several hours after sunset, if not later. Exact timing, we'll just keep fine-tuning as we get closer, which, if nothing else, will keep our lows in the 40s, even low 50s, into the weekend, and then cooling off a little bit around the middle of next week. So no frost in the immediate future. But we'll go for rain Thursday night and Friday, then taper it off on Friday evening to more scattered showers for now, just kind of loose change moving through that upper-level trough, and get temperatures down into the 50s and 60s, which not long ago were your overnight lows, yeah, out of the highs. So that's part of the
I love this time of year.
I do too. It's beautiful.
It's
a couple
nice,
of days. Yeah. You get that fresh, you know, after rain feeling. It clears out the sky, and then it's always nice like it was today.
Really beautiful.
Good way
stuff
to go.
All right.
All right.